Okay, this is the proper procedure for using a valve spring compressor for the pneumatic and the mechanical style. Okay, the very first valve spring compressor that I'm going to be introducing is the mechanical style, and it's a typical one that's used in the industry for removing valves and replacing valves in the cylinder head. The other style that we use here also, and it's typical in the industry, it's for speed and accuracy, is the pneumatic style. Okay, and it can be set up exactly the same way as the mechanical apparatus, except we're using air to assist in the speed of the process. Valve spring compressor, the very first thing is understanding some of the nomenclature related to it. One is the yoke and then the anvil. We also have a trigger mechanism for actually closing this so that we can compress the spring or release the spring in its position once it's properly positioned. Now, first thing we need to do is adjust the yoke so that it fits correctly over the valve spring retainer or valve spring retainer rotator. So we're going to take this apparatus. First of all, we're going to check to make sure that it is in its correct position and it's tight enough. I'll just tighten this up a little bit so that it sits correctly over the spring so it can safely be removed. So looking on the opposite end of the head now, on the valve face side, we want to make sure that we position the anvil directly over the center of the valve. Okay, the next procedure, now that we've already set the yoke dimension to fit the retainer or rotator on the valve end, and we've adjusted the anvil to fit correctly over top of the valve face, we need to install this so it is loose with the clamping device closed. So right now it is loose. One of the biggest mistakes technicians make is they pick it up directly off of the bench and then try to compress a valve at a smaller or larger dimension, giving them trouble in doing the disassembly or reassembly process. So at this position now, I'm just going to recorrect my yoke again now that I'm closer to the position. And I already have the apparatus closed. So what I need to do is wind this down until I have an appropriate dimension to actually cause the valve spring to compress, releasing the keepers just below the rotator, or in this case, the retainer. So if I continue through the process, we crank it down to prevent, or far enough to prevent, no coil bind, because we do not want to cause any of these coils in the wire spring construction to bind against each other, because we could actually break or cause a problem with the integrity of the spring. So once we get down far enough, we can remove the keepers and then release the valve spring and retainer assembly. Now that our tool is set and we've had success removing the first spring, now the tool is set up for removing all the rest of the valve springs in this head configuration. There's no extra setup time. I can compress the next spring, remove the keepers. Once we've removed the keepers, we can remove the next assembly. So now the tool is completely set for disassembly and reassembly in the process.